everyone, and welcome to the Stream TIG channel. So for today's video, we got a little bit of everything. I'm gonna show you here. We got a repair on a SCED 80 10 inch pipe. This is high pressure gas line, so it was x-rayed, as you can see, and there was a repair on the repair, so they x-rayed again, and there's more indication to be fixed on the top part, top section of the pipe. The bottom one is already fixed, it's good, but now they want me to open and fix what's inside. There should be some grip. As you can see, this was on the bottom, it was repaired. One of our guys, it was in turner concavity and porosity. It's a little bit mess. So on the sides, 3 or 9 o'clock, there's supposed to be some grapes, and this is already prepped. He cut through for me, the night shift guy. Yeah, he did a really good job. Kudos to that pipe fitter. So the mark, they want to go a little bit down deeper. They want me to take that off and cut through. So I'm just gonna grab a 1/4 inch grinder. I'm gonna open up, and with a Cubitron, I'm gonna re-bevel, and I'm gonna start taking some meat down from that wall, and try to open up a little bit and see what's going on inside. Okay, as you can see here, as I'm going in, taking on the wall, there's porosity showing up here on the side, close to the edge. Probably that was the root. As you can see here, that's really on the edge. It's like start peeling off. That's why I'm shaving down. That's why I'm taking root, and that's what you have to do. And this is what happened. I'm shaving more and more, taking more meat to make nice and healthy this side of the 90. And as you can see here on the side, that thin film, that's root, that's what it was inside. And I gotta get rid of all that. As you take it more and more, the gap is opening more and more, as you can see here. This is example on the other side. Now I got a bigger gap, so I can see clearly inside. This is root. You know, he had some issue, whoever was welding that. So you can't weld over it. You gotta get rid of that. So you gotta, I gotta open the sides. I gotta get rid of on the other side. As you can see, the leftovers of the root. He was doing very cold. He was probably doing some dipping technique, but a very unfortunately not so successful. He had the grapes on the side, and the gap is getting more and more. So I get to the point where it's already gap almost 20 mil, which is absolutely out of our welding procedure. It's out of code, especially on a high pressure gas line. So in this case, there's no point to fix that. We're just simply gonna get rid of and cut out and put a pop piece inside. And that's exactly what happened. So now we have two joints. It's gonna be 100% x-ray. There's some steel leftovers of porosity on a 90 on that. So we gotta get rid of that. I got two excellent pipe fitters with me. So they did a hell of a job cutting and prepping pipe piece and both sides, 90 and pipe side. And this is much for the fitting, angle iron on the bottom, chain grips, probably use the come along, put everything together. A little bit of gap. It's not gonna be perfect. I mean, it's lots of room. So this is one of my guys. So they wanna make it nice, square, straight as possible. Especially here with the 90, it's a hell of a job, as you guys know, to make especially cut on the 90, to make it really straight and nice and cut. And they did a really good job. So this for the gap, one side is going to be a little bit loose, other side is a little bit wide. Still still doing some fine tunes here. I'm going to weld 1/8. The rod is 80s D2. I put three heavy tacks on the pipe side, and on the 90 I'm just gonna put one tack, and I'm gonna start. This is only one tack on the 90, just to hold that in place. I'm using Big Blue 400, Miller, amazing machine, one of the best machine I love them. I just simply love that machine. Okay, so now for the root pass, I'm running one around 120 amps. I'm just constant feed on the bottom part, back feeding for the bottom section up to that to those tacks, and then later I got to switch on as I got a little bit difference in the gap. So that's the, one of the reasons why I put only one tack on the 90. The other side is open, so the side that's not that open on a little bit tight, this is that's the side I'm gonna root first. As I said, I'm back feeding this bottom section part up to 9 o'clock. That's the root. This is how the root should look like. I don't know what guy did, so we had that repair. As I said, it was like two x-rays and a repair on the repair, and that's what happened. Okay, so in order to make that proper work, you gotta do root on both joints in the same time. So I'm doing bottom section half on the 90 and the other half on the pipe side, and I'm gonna do on the other side as well. As I said, in order to do a proper job, to keep that pop piece to be blended in with that, the rest of the spool, the rest of the pipe, gotta be welded both joints. I'll do what I can't. The goal here is root and hat and ball joints, if it's possible even finish one or two. We'll see how far we're gonna get. It's a hell of a job, especially when it started with the repair. I think it's gonna be minor and then end up to cut out, as you gotta get rid of everything, whatever is left inside, you gotta get rid of and start new root. But as said, it was 20 mil gap, so it's definitely out of our procedure, and that's something you don't wanna do. If it's a water line or a fire line, definitely, yeah, go ahead, no problems. But on a high pressure gas line, definitely you don't want to do that, and it's out of the code and all other procedures. Okay, now I'm routing other side, other joint. As I said, back feed the bottom section. So on the this side, I got a little bit wider gap on this side. I'm just gonna weld close to that tack, and I'm gonna stop. I'm gonna get rid of that tack in order to close that gap a little bit. The puddle really goes nice and smooth. It's not that hard to weld, especially when you got nice prep, good prep. Everything is clean, in and out. As you can see, the good healthy root. That's what you want on the bottom. Okay, now I'm gonna get rid of that tack, and that gap is gonna shrink a little bit, so it's gonna be a little bit. It's a little bit easier to weld. The gap is not so. So heavy, as you're gonna end up with more fill, it's gonna be, you know, more to fill, wider gap, and end up burning more material. Okay, and I'm just gonna continue on. As I said, get rid of the tack. It's still a little bit wide here. I don't wanna lay wire technique here or just constant feed. Just gonna do dipping technique side to side. And I'm slowly progressing up to the top section of that pipe. As you guys, many of you watch my previous videos, or for you who are just tune in and find out for this channel, this is a dipping technique. It's one of my favorite, highly recommended for you guys, especially if you're starters. This is a one of the best technique until you get really good at it, to switch to different techniques. So for 100% x-ray, definitely recommended. Lower your amperage, control your throttle speed. It's a little bit easier to manipulate your puddle. You got overall, you got a very better way better control over your puddle. You can watch how the puddle behaves, and pretty much you got control. Now I'm gonna switch to the other side. Same idea. That's the root. That's the root, the bottom all the way up to the top. The root looks good, looks healthy. That's how the root should look like. Especially if you got 200% x-ray joints. And the client is all over that, so I got a left two windows on the top. He's gonna check root. Okay, now the other side. Same thing, back feed, bottom section up to 9 o'clock, 3 o'clock, depends on which side, what side you're welding, but pretty much that's the idea. Up to 3 o'clock or even less, depends for will be. Then I can gonna close up and I'm gonna start with a hot pass. That's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna close that and do a hot pass on both sides. Okay, and that's it. He was here, happy. So I close the windows and I'm gonna run a hot pass. I run a buffing wheel just to make that root pass clean. Make sure you don't have any obstacles inside the bevel so you can freely walk the cup. You can crank that heat. I was around 180 here for that hot pass. And now I gotta pick and choose. I'm already short with the time, which one I'm gonna weld and finish. So it'll be this one. So that's gonna be the pipe side. And this is a little bit time-lapse. Time-lapse of me filling all the way filter flash with that side. And the other side is I'm gonna leave for my buddy on the night shift to finish that, the rest of the joint. They're really in rush. They wanna x-ray that, make sure everything is okay, hydro test and put back, get ready for service. As I say, guys, take a caution, especially on a pipe like this. You know it's gonna be x-rayed, especially on a high pressure gas line. You know they look for any details. So you want to make sure everything is nice and clean. Clean each pass, make sure everything is good. Make sure all your parts on your torch, your flow, everything is good, in good conditions. Replace any parts that are damaged or about to be damaged, especially if you're running high heat. And for this torch I'm using, it's a heavy heater, 350. It's amazing torch. Helps a lot. Especially when it's not a water cooled torch, it's just air cooled, and it works really fine. And at this point on a cap, I'm gonna go two pass cap, and as I'm using remote, but it's around 200 amps for the cap. That's the beauty of a TIG pipe. You can really run hot. 1/8 ADS2 rod. This is what we use pretty much. It's in our procedure, we use that a lot in power plants. That's the beauty of running hot, especially when you got nice, good, solid foundation for it. TIG pipe, as I said, 200 amps, and then it's really nice and liquid. You can manipulate, you can just play with that puddle. It's just a beauty to watch, and it's a beauty to weld. Okay, now one pass is done on the both sides of the pipe, and I'm just gonna run a second pass here. This is my buddy pipe fitter, great tradesman, excellent pipe fitter. He's just helping me out passing that rods so we can finish that a little bit faster. This is the second pass here. I'm running same amperage, around 200 amps, same rod, 1/8. As I said, guys, make sure it's nice and liquid. Keep that edge straight as possible. You want to make it look nice. It's gonna be good for. It's gonna be eye appealing for the client. And you're gonna look like a superstar. It was a hell of a work here, guys. We did. It's a real action. This is how we do in the field. Finally, some actions. And I gotta say, kudos to my buddies, two excellent tradesmen, pipe fitters, Darren and Francois. Thank you, guys, once again. And that's it, pretty much. This is done. So I finish this joint. The other one is just a root and half pass. So night shift guy Ryan, he's gonna finish the rest, and it's gonna be ready for the X-ray. This is a little bit rush, and that's it. X-ray is done. Everything's good, 100%. No issues, not even one single indication on a bolt joint. So that's very good, and that's what we like it. Hope you guys like it, enjoy it. Subscribe, like, and share. And you got a burn to learn, guys. See you in the next one. Take care.